line is so backed up that the manager came over to help run a register there. So he's in earshot. He's like, uh-oh, let me step in here. And here's the thing. The barcode on there, on the 5-foot section of pipe, was actually the barcode for 10 feet of pipe. And it didn't even faze them. They were like, oh, someone cut the pipe and returned it. Someone
cut it off, brought it back.
Cut it in half, kept the 5 feet for themselves, returned the 5 feet of pipe, and the return counter rung up as 10 feet. They got the full refund, and someone took the half a pipe with the 10-foot barcode on it and put it on a shelf where the 5-foot sections are.
And who gets to pay for it?
And the cameras.
Who? This guy.
Will not help them at all.
This guy right here.
So I ended up with the 5-foot section of pipe with the 10-foot barcode on it.
Wow.
So basically the manager was like, tell you what, this ring up is $20. I'll give it to you for $10. That's half the price. So I'm like, 5-foot section was like $13. So I saved $3 for this trouble. I'm like, yeah, fine, whatever. Great. $10. Let's get out the door. Oh, wow. Okay, here you go. Thank you. Bye.
All so that
there we go.
How much did it cost for you to drive all the way over there, Gators, the second time?
Well, no, I realized it when I got out in the parking lot. So I did, oh, okay. I actually, yeah.
Hey, I just realized now that there's some actually some people. I thought since nobody got to see the intro, and Mars, you haven't seen the intro either.
I heard it twice though.
As Dune asks the blind guy.
Well, one and a half.
I'm not
times.
Making. Yeah, no, there we go.
Do you have any working vision today, Mars?
Do you have any work? Yeah. Can you?
No, and I barely have working breathing either. But you know.
Okay. Oh, well,
God, we're sorry.
That's it's not exciting. Good. It is bad. It is bad.
That's.
But anyway, I'm gonna replay so the people that are actually.
You should replay it.
I should do that. Here we go. This is.
Yeah.
So this is exciting. I actually a project that actually worked. Let's see if I can make this work.
Program is intended for mature audiences.
Don't worry, I'm not gonna hurt you.
Welcome, human. I am ready for you.
We show onboard computer synchronization.
Roger that.
I have come here to chew bubblegum and kick ass. And I'm all out of bubblegum.
Let's
roll!
Oh, you're going straight to hell for that one.
Just the fact, Jack!
Back off, man. I'm a scientist.
Is this moron number one? Put moron number two on the phone.
Now, funny how? I mean, funny like I'm a clown, I amuse you, I make you laugh. What do you mean funny? Funny how? How am I funny?
Yeah, I know that, dude.
You're mocking me, aren't you?
Shh. A monkey's might fly out of my butt.
Ow! My heart just stopped. Ah, there it goes.
So there you go.
Now, we sat there you down. Go. Obi looked at the seeing eye dog.
And then Johnny starts to play.
Then the 27-85.
And that's how we actually started the show right there. So
Yeah, the song's still going. That's how long it is.
That's like an 18-minute song, isn't it?
It's very, very long.
Yeah.
Very long.
Yeah. It's a whole side record.
Dude, I missed your show. I tuned in an side hour one? Late and it was gone.
Well, no, well, actually, I only had an hour show last night because my cocks went bad. Damn.
Oh,
cocks.
I thought it was, you know.
You didn't hear about my cocks last night?
No,
oh, I was all about 12 inches last night and my cocks boom right out the window.
And that's not even the best line he used. That's talking
not,
about it.
No, it's not. It's not
those
the best
blue
line.
Pills don't last as long as they used to, do they?
We were talking about cocks and hookers, by the way. Oh, by the way, Boston yes. Chicky, today's thing we're talking about, I'll read it to you. Scaffolds, plumbers, crack, my cocks, shameless promotions, Twitch fines, and hookers. Hookers.
Oh.
So
you know why hookers? Ask me why hookers.
Dune, why hookers?
Because you. For some why? Reason, Johnny has interjected hookers into my life. That came out wrong.
That was totally wrong there.
Let's back that up a little bit. See,
you know where the whole hooker thing started was when I was talking about Emily's brother got, and you thought I was going to say
a hooker.
Yes. And so you interjected hookers into your life. And I've just decided to never let you forget
it. I don't know if that's true, though. I'm not sure.
That is true. That's absolutely true.
Oh, but you know what? In prepared for that, prepared? No, preparation.
Preparation.
For preparation, yes. I did come up with this, right though. Here.
Well, you got a dead hooker in the trunk.
What? No, it can't be. Yeah, come on
hey,
down.
Hey, here's another dead hooker in this trunk.
What?
This is Dude's garage over here.
What are you doing? I've never seen so many dead hookers in all my life.
So there you go. All right. Wow. Boston, so, you take care. You be careful out there.
Dude has embraced the dead hookers
in his closet. The dead hooker embracement is what we need. It's Sunday, John. Sunday. It's Sunday.
Oh, my God. I just realized I have something.
I was going to say, hookers need love too, but that would have been, that could have gotten weird though.
I'll be right back. I want you to talk about what's going through your mind as I'm cutting pipes and water's coming out.
Yeah. Okay. Oh man. Oh, so anyway, Mars. So luckily he still has all his fingers. He has heat in the house. Uh-huh. And I was so proud of Johnny when he did this, by the way, because I did not give him a chance to get this working. For the people just tuned in, we're talking about Johnny had fixed a pipe downstairs, and he's not.
First of all, who gave him a blowtorch?
That's what I thought. That's what I thought.
And second of all, dude, I have a question for you. This is very important.
Okay.
Why did he buy a snow shovel? He has a blowtorch.
That's true, Johnny.
I just for you, I made a point to get my church receipt.
I wasn't ready, Johnny. I was totally, totally not ready. All right. Look at that.
Yeah. Now they actually have a
Johnny
form
has
in here.
A church receipt. There we go.
They're trying to reach the college students and care packages. So if you have any college kids in your family, you can fill this form out and they'll send a little care package with some notes. And why are they reaching for that age group?
In college, they said this was all bullshit.
So I think they're trying to kind of counteract
that. By the way, I'd like to apologize to the people on YouTube that they missed about 20 minutes of the show, but, you know.
Oh.
There's too many. Mars, there's too many damn buttons. It's buttons everywhere.
You have the boom button. Doesn't do everything.
Got it. You would think it would.
Wait, why does YouTube have to be turned on separately from all the other videos?
Here's the thing. I use a Restream service, and I have to turn YouTube off when I do the 5-Hit show. Because if I don't, I wake up to about however many songs I play that night. That's how many.
You have like...
Yes. How many
emails?
Yes. First of all, they block the video so it can't. The funny thing, they'll let it go out once. YouTube is strange about that. Unless there's like, you know, boobies flying or something like that, they will block you for playing music the second time. But the first time, it's like they let it by. Now they don't. So far, I haven't gotten a cease and desist letter. It's just been a, hey, you did this, you shouldn't have done this, but we're going to monetize it, whatever. But it ends up being it just blocks it everywhere. So, but I forget about it.
If they can't monetize it because they can't divvy up the monetization 50 ways.
50 ways. So that's like, right. That's right.
Screw it. We're turning this one off.
That's like, there's like 7 to 9 people that watch it. They're not going to do this. It's not going to happen.
So if you could throw in what I've done wrong as I explain what I did do, because at the end I succeeded. So I turned off the furnace. Mm-hmm. I turned it off. I had 3 places to turn it off, so I was triple off because there's a red
off. I like that.
Well, there's a red switch on the furnace. There's mm-hmm. a red switch next to the basement door, and plus I know which switch in the breaker box turns off the furnace. So I flipped all 3 of those off just to make sure that's because I know I want that off. I hook up hoses. I open up spigots. Water comes out. Eventually, water
I need
stops.
To learn how to say these names. How do you pronounce that? Somebody, thank you for following, by the way. Appreciate it.
Yeah, thank you. And welcome. And welcome to this educational
educational
video
thing.
About plumbing.
About plumbing.
and what not to do.
Crack so, is optional. At this, just saying.
At this point, I've decided I've drained anything that I can. Let's cut into this pipe and see what happens. And I got my bucket ready. So I got my pipe cutter. You know, got it on kind of firm, but not too firm. Turn, tighten a little bit. Turn, tighten up a little bit. Turn, and then some drips come out, and the drips turn to a stream. And I'm like, okay, this is good. This is good. If I just don't cut the pipe anymore, I have a solid stream that's coming out that's a controlled flow that I can just let leak into this bucket until it stops, because it's got to stop eventually.
Right.
And that was good. And that's when I started sending the first pictures of Dune, like, hey, look it, I got a water flow out my pipe. It's all good. Like,
now listen, it's cold as shit outside. I'm sorry. This is not a good time to not have heat. And you picked the perfect time to fix the heater, by the way, Johnny. Why not wait until it's sub-zero outside? That just makes total sense.
The house was warmed up. The house never dipped below 60 throughout this process.
That's cold.
It's like, you know what? The funny thing is, I just realized something too. This popped into my head later as I was watching the kids in the bouncy castle, which is what I was doing. I was, you know, the 4-year-old twins.
Yeah. Aw, did you join them, Dune?
Well, no, but I took a lot of pictures because that was my job. Okay. But I'm sitting there the whole time, and I'm trying to explain to Johnny, because we're talking about, because it starts, this is the funny thing, is I realized that in my eyes, this whole conversation started off as Johnny asking me, hey, should I fix this? He already had that in his mind. This was getting fixed. Yes. He was just waiting for me to talk him out of it. Well, the whole thing, while I'm sitting, because I'm...
I was waiting for you to talk me through it.
Well, okay, that too.
Not out of it.
But I just realized, I'm sitting there talking to you about this, and I'm going like, yeah, I said, well, that's all. I said that's probably an outside wall in this. And then Johnny has to pop off and go, well, Dune, technically all walls are outside walls. Did Johnny just get shitty with me? No, I wasn't sure.
My God.
I always look for the accurate answer to a question. When someone asks me a question, I want to answer them accurately. Now, this is a basement, so the other side of the bottom half of the wall is ground. But at the level of the pipe, yeah, that would be
And that's what I told him. I said, this is what happened is when this house was unoccupied, it broke there is what happened. It froze, just not enough to split it, but enough to just, you know, enough to hit the microphone and make it make noise. But enough to, you know, aggravate, is that the term?
Uh-huh.
Okay. Aggravated. So, luckily, thank God. And I am proud of you, Johnny. I am extremely proud of you. My freaking out about the whole thing had to do with just, I knew enough about Johnny's, you know, it's a closed loop water system that it was kind of like, oh my God, this is not just easy.
We'll get to that part.
Yeah, go ahead.
We'll get to that part. Because everything I read online talked about bleeding it out by, you know, turning things. They didn't talk about how to put water back in it.
Yes.
So I just figured that it would automatically happen. Because there's
this auto water valve.
So I think what I did was I just drained a section of my loop. Because, you know, this loop dips down in the basement, dips up a few places, dips down, dips up. So I really just kind of emptied out like two of my radiators, because this was a section of pipe that joins two radiators that are on either side of the front door. So this pipe's running under where my front door is. And so I just really just drained those sections of my downstairs loop, which is only like, you know, what, like 15, 20% of the loop. So I still had like 80% of my water in the loop.
He still had his loop.
Because by opening up spigots and draining water, all that did was drain whatever was in the furnace, which was pointless and just did nothing but waste a bunch of hot water. You live, you learn. Eventually, at some point, the leak in the pipe started speeding up furiously. And I was like, oh no, it's going to blow. And as I type in the text to Dune, like, it's picking up speed. All of a sudden, it stopped, and it stopped.
Now, keep in mind, like I said, for the people out there tuning, I'm, you know, 4-year-olds, twins, bouncy castle, Dune, camera in one hand, phone in the other. You know, reading the tweet. Oh my God! Now there's water. Oh, geez, this is not going to turn out well.
In the bucket. It's all in the bucket.
Yes.
And so at this point, it's just kind of dribbling and stopping. So at that point, I finished my cut. And I let the rest drain out, and I cut the other section of pipe, and you know, it stopped dribbling. Paper towels. I dried what was there, so I made sure I didn't have any more dribbling and had dry pipe. And I got my brush and cleaned up my hands.
Because we all need dry pipe. You know what I'm talking about here. In a world.
Yeah.
In a world where dry pipes happen.
At this point, there's 10,000 videos that show you the next part of my process. You know, flux, connectors, heat.
88 miles an hour. Solder. Oh, wait, wrong flux. Now, sorry. Sorry.
Now, at some point, I did send you the picture of everything.
I had to throw that in there.
Dude, he has to capacitate that flux first.
That's right.
And I wanted to make sure you knew I did have a fire extinguisher handy.
You did.
I made a point to put that in frame. And just as I finished the last solder connection, my phone starts a vibrating. Call me now!
Oh, God. Dude, you got to call me. Because I'm sitting there thinking, holy shit, Johnny.
And that's when we had the conversation about, well, what about the air that's in the system now?
Yes.
And I'm like, wait, what?
What? Air? Air? Air?
You know, because... I had turned the furnace back on, mm-hmm. and the pipe is warming up, so I know water is still flowing through my heating circuit. So I'm like, I think I'm mostly good, but then that's nagging at me because, well, he's right. Air went in. Air's got to come out somewhere, and it's certainly not coming out of my sink. That's isolated from that anyways. And so I'm like, oh, my God, he's right. I've got air. Because now I'm hearing water flow, and I'm starting to think, do I normally hear water flow like that? Or is the water flowing more because there's air? Because
there's
water.
Air in there going.
Because I never paid attention to what sounds my heater makes. So I can't even compare it to anything. Because I know it makes like, you know, clunk, 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 as things are expanding. But that's, you know, normal. So I'm like, do I normally hear
for the
hear
people
water
out
flow?
There, if your heater's making that sound, call a professional. Just saying.
No, the clunk, clunk, Johnny. Clunks are in. No, the clunk clunk clunks are the sound of the pipes expanding. I've had that sound since day one. It's okay. Not coming from the furnace. It's coming from the heat.
That
the
you're used to pipes. Rattle pipes, pipe rattle. There we go.
Yeah, is there a way to get rid of that? Because he's got to make things expand, right?
Well, the way to get rid of that is the pipes were not installed correctly, so you'd have to like open the walls up. Which you know how that turned out.
Well, no, none of these pipes are on walls.
Well, then you just have to isolate them so they don't rattle.
So I just need to change more pipes.
No, you got to put mounts on them so they don't rattle against it. What it is they rattle when you turn them on and off. They go.
No, I'm not getting rattling. I'm just kind of getting a like clunk clunk.
Then I got nothing.
As they expand.
This is me with nothing.
I'm just like he's gonna make pipes expand. That's gonna make noise.
Yes.
You know, that's just part of.
It's
an old house.
I got you. Johnny's
old house. Yeah,
this old house, Johnny style, is what this is.
Okay. Yes, that's right.
But he has a.
This ain't Bob Vila's house.
No,
that's for sure.
Well, but, you know what? But, Bob Vila wouldn't have done it either. He'd have had Norm do it. Think about that. Let that sink in.
Like, you do that.
Let that sink in right there.
I thought Norm usually did the woodworking.
He does. Norm does everything. Bob
Vila's
not
everything.
Doing the work. Bob Vila's talking about the work. Big difference.
He used to swing a hammer now and then, but that's a bad.
Yeah, but come on.
Yeah, Norm did more of the work.
Norm was the one making it happen. He was the one. There might have been some swinging a hammer.
It's great fun watching the real. It's real fun watching the early seasons of this old house when it was actually a do-it-yourself type of a show. Nowadays, it's showing you all the different contractors you need to hire for this old house.
There was one that had a guy and a girl. What was that one called? It was a KPTS thing.
I don't
thing,
remember.
But it was a guy and a gal. And here's the whole thing. They would build houses together.
I actually enjoyed that one better.
Oh, it's great. Anybody in the chat rooms can remember who that is.
What was great was that they would show bloopers at the end.
It was Home Time.
Home Time. That's it.
That's right.
I got to bring this up. I've got to bring this up. Because I have a story about this. Let's see. Home Time. Because
they would stage phone calls so that like as this thing is ending, the camera turns and this phone call is happening. Just like it's isn't it magical
now,
that time so perfectly?
Now, let me see.
No, this is scripted.
The question is, I think there are two girls in it. There was the first one, then I think there was a second one later on.
Well, here's the thing. Let me see if I can bring – this is – oh, God, this is a horrible freaking picture. I gotta find a better. I gotta find a better picture.
You gotta find a better picture. Well,
I may. You know what? It's gonna have to be the horrible picture. It's just gonna have to be the horrible picture.
Okay.
Hang on. Somebody is calling. Hang on. Here we go.
That is a pretty horrible picture.
That's a horrible picture. NHB, you're on the air.
On the line.
Are you there?
Yeah, I'm here.
What's up, dude? Okay, hey, hold that thought. So anyway, home time. This is how it started. This was the guy. This was the girl. And I think this was her name was I think it was Joanne because he always called her JoJo. If I remember right. Now, watching this, they would go and they would do projects together. They would, you know, hammer. I got to be careful about this.
They would show them
talking before they actually went to the site. And sometimes like sitting in a kitchen drinking coffee, like in the morning. Here's where it gets weird. They're not married. They were never married. A matter of fact, not only were they not married, but they started changing. Different people, different partners. I mean, it started out. Mm-hmm. Next thing you know, it's a different JoJo. Next thing, I mean, it starts getting.
Yeah, you
weird.
Just said too. I'm like, what
yes.
Happened?
I was like, hey, what's wait a one? Minute. That's not the same girl. That's not the same one.
She's a little younger. That's what happened?
They started anyway. So I thought that was kind of interesting. Hey, by the way, who just followed? I missed something here. Accra. Something Bullsacks. I should start learning how to read these better.
We should stop calling our viewers Bullsacks.
We shouldn't call it. Let's not call the viewers.
Could you read that name properly, please? Because I don't see it.
Bullsax.
Okay, it is Bullsacks.
It's just Bullsacks.
Well, welcome Bullsacks. Well, I thought you were insulting our viewers.
I was not. Guys. So what's going on, Farrell?
I'm not sure that you can show in other side on your channel. I mean, like Twitch, because it's breaking the terms.
Well, when they kick me off, I'll worry about it.
Because I was linking some other website and they didn't like that. So.
Oh well, you're probably right. You're probably right. But it's one of those things. I started. By the way, Farrell does a lot of casting on iVlog, which I'm on. And the reason I've kind of stuck with iVlog is because they were kind of my first site that I was on. So I kind of feel like it's kind of a home thing. But I've really spent a lot of time building the Twitch channel, which is starting to actually gain It's starting to gain some traction. And I know what you're talking about. And so far they haven't really said anything. But I mean, if they ever do, then I'll pop off. But I appreciate you worrying about me because I know what it is. You just don't want me to go. All of a sudden they go like, hey, Dune, guess what? Your logon doesn't work anymore.
Oh, by the way, the viewer is Arcade Bull Sacks. So like a bull that plays a saxophone.
Oh,
so
there we go.
Sax. So
arcade our ball apologies. Sax. Sorry.
Welcome here.
Not ball Mr. sax. This is the thanks they get for following. Thank you. I'm sorry.
No, my mistake. I'm sorry.
There we go.
Okay.
And Farrell looks cool. He looks so intense today. Oh, I guess that's just a picture. That's why.
He was very intense.
Yeah, that's me. That's
taken.
My picture. Yeah.
He doesn't have. I thought he was going to have his. There we go. Because we could have put you on the big screen there. There we go.
Yeah.
Anyways.
There you go.
So once I started doing search terms on bleeding air, because the thing was, is before I changed the pipe, I was Googling how to bleed water out of a heating system. Searching on how to bleed air out of a heating system. Completely different search that actually shows stuff that matches up with what I have. And there's basically, I had two spigots and the one that was on the top, there was a lever underneath that. And I flipped that to basically close it off. So that closes a loop with the loop ending at the spigot.
Yes.
And if you open that up and water drains out of there, that makes it pull water in. From
I'll be
the
right
main,
back, guys.
Which is now turned on. Cool.
All right. We'll be here.
And then also you have your valves for your different zones of loops, which are normally set to automatic, but you could set them to be manually on. And so through that, I was able to basically pull water through my loops and have a hose that spit a bit and then stop spitting. And I think I bled the air out of the system and my house is still warm. So I think I'm good.
I like that.
So thank you,
it is. There we go. I have to say again, Johnny, proud of Johnny.
And I didn't even need a scaffolding.
Proud of Johnny. Absolutely. Awesome stuff. Awesome stuff.
So next week I'm going to put in the new electrical system with them, some more outlet. No,
why not, Johnny? Do you gonna is it 220 or 221? Whatever it takes, right?
Yeah. 220,
whatever it takes. Yeah, that's one of those things. Whatever. Put our pump. Oh, wow. There we go. Sorry, I was a little slow on the draw there. Thank you. See, my week wasn't as exciting as yours starting off. I mean, really, my whole week was, I did get my my NAS installed, which is my RAID array and my NAS RAID array that I've got.
Yeah.
I can actually
do
temperatures.
Did you get a nice Synology Dune?
Did I do what?
Did you get a nice Synology Dune?
What are you calling me? What are you calling me? What?
It's a RAID.
Oh.
A Synology.
I thought you were calling me a name.
Yeah, your place is getting raided because of all the dead hookers.
Sorry, wasn't ready for that. So anyway, I'm on Woot because all the great things come from Woot. Mm-hmm. And there's a QNAS they have for sale. And of course, like anything else, I can't just buy it. No. See, this is where Johnny's gotten me back, because I have to go and bug Johnny and say, hey, Johnny, what do you think about this? I have to go bug Rico. Hey, Rico, what do you think about this? And the funny thing is both Johnny and Rico do what I've already done, which is go and look at the feedback. And it says, hey, this is pretty good, or this is that, or this is whatever. And so that's what we both ended up doing. So I ended up getting this thing. Because here's the thing.
It had mostly favorable reviews. So I was it looks all right.
I had purchased 3 8-gigabyte external hard drives.
Wow, those are sucky. Only 8 gigs?
A year ago.
A year.
And they're still sitting. They were still sitting in the box.
Wait. 8 gig or 8 tera?
8 terabytes.
Yeah,
sorry.
I'm hoping it's terabyte. 8 terabyte. Gigabyte would
sorry. Excuse the out of me. Holy crap.
I do have humiliation.
Sorry.
I do still have a few 8 gig ID drives. No, these
8 terabytes. Sorry. Now here's the thing about these damn things. I don't know if you want to talk about fun. Try to take one of those freaking enclosures apart. That's not supposed to be taken apart. Not easy. You have to basically. You got to break them open, basically.
They don't want you to do that because they charge more for the ones that don't come with the.
They actually. So anyway, so I break these things out. I get the RAID installed. I have to go through and figure out how to do it. And so it's working now. So far, so good. I've got backups now. I got everything backing up to it. I can tell you what the temperature is. I'm that cool now. I can do the RAID array temperature.
We could do a RAID array temperature check.
Absolutely. Should we do that? I don't think I have the sound effects to go with it.
You know, if we're going to steal PTR's bit, we should probably also steal the annihilation principle. But never mind.
No, oh, John, no, Johnny, no, Johnny,
no,
Johnny,
no,
Johnny.
I didn't actually follow through on that thought.
Johnny.
I'm just saying.
Okay.
We're going to check temperatures.
For the people out there, because Nana Paula's in the room, I'm not even going to tell you what Johnny's talking about. We're just not going to do it.
There was a guy by the name of Greg.
Stop. Johnny. There we go.
I thought it was Lem. L-E-M.
Okay. Is this... This is not going to... This is not going to come
focusing.
Up. It's not going to focus. Anyway, it is 102 degrees Fahrenheit.
Wow.
And the fan is going 660 RPM per minute.
You know, I have a funny story about this.
Wait, whoa. About what? Tread lightly, my friend.
About promotions for shows.
Okay.
Oh.
God, I'll do this.
This can go so sideways.
Go many ways.
Sideways.
I will dance around the topic.
Okay.
So this is back when I was working as a bank teller up in Maine. And no, this is back when I was working in IT up in Maine.
If you see me drinking and you're getting ready to say something that might make me spew my drink, you will tell me.
You might spew your drink at some point.
There we go. Hey, by the way, wait a second. Johnny, what's the name? Somebody just followed again. Who is, can you read that, please?
Well, the our vMix chat window goes on top of half of the message, so I can see Fod a Mighty 3C.
Thank you, Fod a Mighty 3C. Thank you for following. Thank you for following. Thank
and
you.
And I'm sorry I can't see the rest of your name, and Dune can't read. But
son of a bitch.
Ow. Wow.
There's a lot of love in this room.
Someone threw out an SOB there.
There it is, man. So I'm sorry.
I kid. I kid.
Continue on.
Anyways. Come on. So I started doing the internet radio show, and I was visiting some old coworkers at the branch I used to work at as a bank teller. And I was telling them, yeah, I'm doing internet radio. And they're like, oh, where is it? I'm like, oh, it's over in the, you know, the Holds Barred Radio Network.
I thought he was going to say old hooker.
Dune, you have to bring up the sound now.
Okay. I didn't even get
to the funny part.
That's a pretty good sound, by the way. Never mind.
I gotta reach over here.
Right here.
I gotta reach over here.
You got a dead hooker in the trunk. Oh, what? God. No! It can't be. Yeah, come on.
Hey,
down.
Hey, here's another dead hooker in this trunk.
What?
I apologize to the people out there.
Oh, my goodness.
What are you doing?
I've never seen so many dead hookers in all my life.
Okay, Keytronics. Yeah, you know what I'm gonna have to do? I'm gonna have to give him some way to actually remotely hit the beat button.
Yeah,
I think we can make that happen.
No. Well, I'm not gonna say any. I wasn't gonna say hookers, I'm gonna dance around this.
Okay.
So, I'm talking to my former coworkers, telling them about this internet radio I'm doing, and mm-hmm. so I bring up the website to show them the website that, you know, I do the internet radio on, and the Annihilation Principle used to have a banner. Ad that would come up sometimes that included a picture of a thermometer with a caption of what the thermometer was used for.
Yes.
And that happened to be the banner that loaded the day I showed my coworkers there. And one of the coworkers, her name was Deb, and she points at it and goes, well, that looks interesting. And,
wow. That's funny.
What that will always make me think of.
Oh, man. I'm trying to find the Wayback Machine because there is still a chance. What year would you think that would be?
I don't know, but I think I have that one saved somewhere. I have a bunch of those old ones.
Here's the thing. I didn't do that. Oh, that's NHP Radio. There we go. .com. There we go. Would that be like around what year would you say that was? Like 07 maybe? Or maybe 2011. I don't know. What would you think?
Let's see. There's Ray Charles. I totally have this and I can send it to you. There it is. So that's TAP. All right. I can send you this file. I'll send it to you on the messenger. Let's see if I can just drag and drop.
That whole thing totally didn't work there. Okay. Yeah. Go ahead and do that. Let's see. Do I even have? Yes, I do. I do have that up. I do. I have it up. It's up. No, I'm not going to say it's up in that.
Oh, well, let me drag and drop. All right. Let me browse.
There we go. All right.
So you want to go
here? Johnny is
browsing.
There we go. He's trying.
Okay.
So, he's trying. He's working on it.
Well, the thing is it shows me a search result, but it doesn't show me what path it was actually in, because that would be useful information, Windows. But I'm trying to do open the path location or open the All right. It's somewhere on this darn drive. I don't want to create a new video. What the heck are you talking about?
Can you right-click and go to properties and up there, up on the second tab? I think there's a thing to where the path is.
What could go wrong?
Properties, details, attributes, no. Security, no. General. Oh, there we go. It's under D, old NHB storage, old website artwork.
This sounds...
banners. TAP
click on it.
0001.
Click on it.
There we go.
There we go.
So that is the banner ad that showed up when I was showing my former coworkers.
It's not actually, well, it's sort of coming up. There you go.
There it is.
There you go. And for the people that, yes, that's that says exactly what he says it says.
Yes. That was the banner ad with the thermometer and a description of what the thermometer was used for.
Yes. And sadly enough, we don't know if it was true, and we really don't want to know.
That's, he kept reading off numbers periodically. That sounded correct.
Absolutely did.
Now, here's the thing. I don't. He went through a number. He didn't just keep using the same thermometer, because he actually was like giving away used thermometers as telethon.
That just sounds terrible. You know what we should do? We should move beyond that.
He never sent me mine. He never sent me
mine. You know, I want to transition to something, and I don't know how to do it without being creepy.
Go ahead.
I want to transition from that to something else, but, oh, God, I'm going to go to hell for this.
Could you clean up what you transitioned to and see if I can help you do it? Every now and then I don't.
Okay, I can't. As a matter of fact, Mars, you're here. You can actually. I found a song. I found a song on iTunes.
That's not.
And I wanted to see if Johnny could maybe figure out whose song this might be.
Who, as in who did it, or who is it for?
Who's singing the song?
Who's singing the song?
Who is the artiste? Okay, I'm gonna go ahead. Okay. And this has nothing to do with what we just talked about, by the way. Nothing. Just saying. Okay, here we go.
One, two, three.
See if Johnny can figure it out. Guesses?
I don't know this one.
Are you sure? Listen to the voice very closely.
Oh, can you feel it? No, you can feel it too. The beautiful world is tingling. Oh, can you feel it? No, you can feel it too.
Let's see if this helps. Does that help? Johnny.
Oh, is that the EP?
There you go. Bobby Reed, or Red.
Bobby Red.
That's her. Nice. I want to say that's her stage name, because that makes it sound creepy. But she actually has a couple of EPs out there.
Oh, nice.
Isn't that cool?
That is.
So that is the girl. And she's one of these. I don't know which one. I'm guessing this one. Just saying. I don't know. I could be wrong. I'm thinking that's probably her.
That looks right.
But there you go, the girl from That Jam Show.
Yeah,
who's actually out on doing other stuff at the moment. So I thought that was kind of cool.
Now, did we find any other recordings from other Jam Show members?
There are, but I thought I would just. I don't want.
You gotta do one at a time.
I'm not even gonna tell you what I was getting ready to say. I said, I don't want to, well, I was going to say, I don't want to blank all at one time. Doing that makes it sound worse.
Just stop. Just stop. We like these guys, and we want them to keep listening to our show.
Yes, we don't want to,
Let's not creep out the Jam Show,
creep out the Jam Show. Let's creep on the damn show? That damn show, this could be the new one.
Jam.
There we go. Anyway, great song. She's got great sound. Kind of country-ish. So there you go. I thought that was kind of cool. I thought maybe he'd catch it.
Yeah.
Now that you hear the voice,
why
you
was
know
in that mind frame.
Now that you hear the voice, you go, "That's her. That's definitely her.
That's her. That's Jam."
So you can tune in Tuesday night and not hear her again. She's not.
Wait. Where do I find this?
Tuesday
show?
Night on Twitch, and I'll tweet it out, because I always do.
I have to type in the Jam Show.
The Jam Show.
That jam show.
Here, let me
Click
the shirt.
Just click the tweet, because Dune and I always retweet.
Here we go.
I don't actually do Twitch.
Of course,
that.
This is what Dune does. I buy their merchandise.
Oh.
And then I tweet out show things for myself, in hopes that they will
see their apparel and retweet it.
And Sadly, they do it. They always hit retweet.
Oh yeah.
The other people, the other people, the merch I've bought, not so much. They like it. That doesn't do. They realize it doesn't do me any good.
You get enough of this, you can go full five hit at night on Saturdays with their music.
Here's the thing. That's true. They had two buttons they could have picked. They could have picked the button with the heart or the button with the two arrows.
It's right.
I think the heart expresses more emotion than two arrows.
It does, but it doesn't get me listeners, though. That's the problem. That's the issue.
You don't want love. You want listeners.
Hey, by the way, it's just, I could have sworn that was Kevin Reeves. No, not Kevin Reeves. Close. Oh, by the way, did you see who that was? That's our. I had your picture up earlier, by the way.
Yeah, that's the guy Dune wanted me to hire to do the plumbing.
That's the guy. That's the guy.
Oh, he's got a janitorial shirt on, so he would have done a better job of. No, I did plenty fine plumbing. There we go. Solder sucked right in.
What no I tell you weeks, what, Mars, no do you want to stick around while we do the Twitch finds of the week? You're more than welcome.
I would mute and listen, but yeah.
Oh, well, if you're going to do that, then go ahead. Just listen on air, then. We'll let you go.
Well, no, you can chime in.
Right. Well, that's cool, because you might chime in.
You never know what we're going to find, you know?
That's true. Okay. The only thing I'm going to do...
I've started listening to Twitch once in a while. Yeah. I have an app for my Apple TV now.
There we go. Oh, it's great. It's great. They have a fail alarming channel that I watched that for 5 hours today.
Really? Oh. I didn't know they had that.
I watched Bob Ross at 5 o'clock.
Bob Ross gets thousands of people watching, by the way. Let that sink in while I'm sitting here struggling to get anybody to watch me.
He's dead, and he gets way more viewers than us.
Yes, isn't that
he's
great?
Got better hair. You got to admit, his hair is awesome.
He has good hair. But, there we go. But yeah,
the Fail Army channel is live 24/7, and I watched it. I think Megan Lenius is live right now.
She is. She always goes live when I'm on. It never fails. No, and I love watching her too in that non creepy way.
Oh yeah.
The L word. You gotta be careful with that. People are like, oh God, he's a stalker. No, not a stalker.
No. You've been cool. No one here is.
Yeah, be cool. Be cool.
We've not creeped out Megan Lenius yet.
I go into her channel, and I say hello, and she says hello back, and then we just, everything's cool from then on.
And I don't think she knows that I'm the guy that she supposedly called out. So because I show up there too.
We have no idea. Okay.
I don't know if she. I still say that I was right too.
Well, you probably were. So anyway, to the max.
Yeah.
There we go. For the people who tune in every week, the Dune and Bob Show, one of the things we like to do is feature and find great new talent and just people, fun people on Twitch, usually in the IRL or the chat sections. There are lots of music sections I do. And by the way, I do have a kick-ass artist spotlight this week. So that's going to happen.
And chicken suits will get you bonus points.
Chicken suits, if you try to get featured here. If you could be the guy with the chicken suit, that would be awesome. Okay, so let's just start. I'm going to have to go through these pretty quick because I didn't realize that we're good. This one here. So what I do basically, I sit down with my iPad during the week, and I flip through Twitch and I find stuff. Listen, for the people out there that don't know, we're not bagging on anybody here. This is fun stuff.
This is all good fun.
This is people having a good time doing what they do. I make lots of recordings, and I don't keep a whole lot of them either. I mean, it's just this happens as it happens. I'll go into a channel. I'll hit record. And if there's nothing good, I keep it. If nothing, I'll let it go. This one here, I kept for the sole reason of just what she said. This is very short.
Shit.
That's why I got that one.
I just like
the way she said shit. That was sheet.
It's a sheet.
There you go. So there you go. If you'd like to follow her, Billy Chow. And she was cooking on Sundays. So this was last.
I don't speak her language. So
there we go. Now this one here, I clipped this for a reason. I've noticed that lots of people on Twitch, and they're usually people not from around here, either Russia or other countries. They'll watch American movies and they'll narrate them. But the funny thing is every once in a while, you'll catch an American movie that has not subtitles, but they've actually redone the audio. Let's see if I can turn this up so you can hear it. It just sounds funny.
Oh, this is a classic movie.
It's a classic movie. But that is the Russian version of, what's the guy's name now? There we go. Thank you. Thank you, Johnny.
Me, myself, and Irene. The movie that gave us the angry drums.
Yes, exactly.
Was that the Russian Jim Carrey?
The Russian Jim Carrey, yes. Actually. Hey, oh, somebody followed us. Who was that? Who followed us here? I can't read it.
I can't see because it's white on white. That's why I don't.
Thank you for following, by the way, whoever that is. Thank you. This one right here, I think there's another word in there.
Okay, so we got a dancing Pikachu.
Yep.
El punto siempre urgente. Bueno, vamos a seguir viendo clips, ¿no? A ver.
I don't know what she's saying, but I like it.
Oh, fuck.
Oh, okay.
So I like that. It's a universal language. You burp and say OF.
All right. I'm done.
That's what you do. So if you want to follow her, there she is right there. Oh, that's not her. That is so not her.
That's her in the corner.
That's her in the corner. There we go. This here was interesting. This was kind of a show within a show of somebody that was doing something
like Munch Squad.
Yes, so that's what this is. This guy has flattened out a frying pan.
Oh, come on.
An actual frying pan. He flattened it out, and now he's rolling this thing up. I'm guessing this is not the guy you want to piss off. Just saying.
Just saying. So let's not make fun of him.
Yeah, let's not make fun of this guy.
It's still going.
And I just thought it was, what I thought was cool was watching the guy that was actually doing the filming of it, the other guy. So I don't know what channel he was on. But I always wondered what kind of rigs they had, so I'm assuming a lot of people have stuff like that. But can you believe that? He actually took a frying pan, flattened it, and then rolled it up. So, yeah, this is not the guy you want to make mad. Now, for the people out there that think if you don't have talent, you can't be on Twitch, not true.
There's plenty of channels that...
Not true. Mars, can you guess what's going on here?
Somebody sleeping during their show?
That would be it.
Mars, you've done that.
Now, what I don't understand...
There's been other people that slept in their show, too.
He has some goals up top for donations. And one is for being on drugs, and one not for being on drugs. So that's what I saw, and I had to click on it. So there we go.
Goals for drugs and no drugs.
And I like this auditory ASMR.
And he had four viewers.
Yes, four viewers watching him sleep, including myself. This guy I thought was cool. This guy's a guitar player. I got a couple of different guitar players on here. What I thought was interesting, he's using a green screen, so behind him is a superimposed picture. And I thought it was interesting that most people use green screens because they're like, they have a messy room behind them. I'll just let this go here. I'll turn this down a bit here.
This guy green screened a messy room. Man.
Yes, he green screened a messy room. Exactly. So you have to give him credit for, this is him going like, yep, that's the way it works.
I'm going to green screen, but I'm going to be honest.
That's right. I'm going to be honest about it. I do like that he has the lamp with the lady on it. That's kind of cool. Oh, I just noticed this. Wait a minute. Whoa, wait just a minute. What is going on right here? What the hell is this? I missed that, Johnny.
I think we all know what's going on there. There are two kinds of people. There are people that use socks, and there's people that use paper towels.
Okay,
this guy is of the second group.
It's great. He's a guitar player, Johnny. He's a guitar player.
Yeah.
And good the guitar player, by the way. This was kick-ass. I like finding people like this that can actually just turn a camera on and then jam like this. Very cool. So let's go up and down.
That's pretty good.
Zoom in so you can hear the guy. That's the cat's name right there. Jiggle Bill. G-I-G-G-L-E. Bill. There you go.
With paper towels.
Yes, with paper. Yeah. I don't even want to tell you what it was. I really don't. We found these guys last week, Johnny. These were the guys last week talking about Dracula.
Oh, those guys.
These guys. The conspiracy guys.
Because guess what? Because we're back. We're back.
They're back.
We're back, and you better believe it. We're back and better than ever.
And they have an intro. They were getting
this
ready.
Is why you wanted an intro.
They were going to do headlines. They got a great intro, by the way. Listen to it. I like that.
It's almost Knight Rider.
It is kind of Knight Rider-ish.
Custodial staff points out that that room was Carl's room from Aqua Teen Hunger Force.
So, oh, okay.
That explains paper towels and lotion.
Song about Halloween of all time? Monster Mash. Right, but now science Game understands over. Why.
But that was it. Those guys are great.
So I kind of want to watch them.
If you want to go follow them, that's cool. Now the funny thing is, right after I found them, and this guy I love watching too. I find this guy.
We know about technologies. We know about alien technologies. We just know there's just so many people who have come forward, unimpeachable. Mm-hmm. People.
And look at the fun stuff he has around his room.
That have come forward and we've
got
seen
the alien head. He's got the lava lamp. We know what he's got the JFK bust. I'm not. This. I don't know if this is a butt bottle opener or boob bottle opener. I'm not sure.
Either way, it's a good time.
It's a good time.
Works in tandem with them.
I do like that he is a Star Wars fan. Han shot first.
Han did shoot first.
Okay.
President Obama didn't have to deal with this stuff.
And we do have a few new followers.
There we go. Oh, I'm sorry. Did I miss a follower?
Yeah, but I can't read them because of the way to lay it overlays. The custodial staff is following. But before that, disgusting murder. I don't know. You know what? I need to actually join the room.
You should join the room so you could actually see it. That would be such a great idea. Awesome.
So that I can actually read the chat
there we
instead
go.
Of trying to read your overlay.
So by the way, we spoke of That Jam Show. This is That Jam Show. And I clipped this because the guitar dude was doing a little solo, and I thought he should totally do his own show. He could do it, man. He could pull it off.
Are you breaking up the Jam Show? That Jam Show?
No, 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 no. An additional show. A spinoff.
Let's not do that.
A spinoff. He does his thing on, say, Thursdays after the Tuesday show. So, I thought that, I don't know why, I happened to like that. I thought that was cool.
So Disgusting Man 8 is our new follower.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Yeah.
Now, I mentioned last week that on that jam show, they were going to play a song for me that I asked them to learn.
Yes.
Guess what they learned?
And they did a great job of it.
Guess what they learned?
Is it level 42?
That's the next one I'm going to have them do.
That's the next one.
I had them do this one. I had them do Return of the Mac. Now, and Guitar Dude's ready.
You think they could learn a Milton Babbitt song?
Possibly. Possibly.
Lots of bells and...
The only thing I think they could have done that would have helped this, I think they need to mic up the drum player. I think he needs a microphone.
Or...
Just so he can sing.
Let's see, kick, two on the snare, another two on the toms. Yeah. And a pair of overheads. I think we need 7 mics for him.
Yeah, 7 mics. There we go.
At least.
But these are the guys, they all live in a house together in Canada, and on Tuesdays, they jam. That's our story, and we're sticking to it.
And it's true. They confirmed it last
They did
week.
Confirm it. Absolutely confirmed it. You know what I tell you is really versatile in this band? Is this cat right here. The guy playing the bass right now, he's kind of like the jack of all trades. He can play the bass. He can play the drums. I've seen, and of course, he plays the bongos normally.
Yeah. It's kind of throw wherever they need him.
So there you go. I'm going to have to move on because, like I said, we're getting tight on time here.
But yeah, it was awesome. When they
what
did,
was this one here? Oh, here's another song. Another song they did a great job on. Since I got the shirt on, I figured I had to feature him a little bit. But it's just fun to watch him do this live. And it's not the same without the other girl, but, you know.
Oh, they're still great.
Yeah, they're still great. But you know what? The guy with the guitar, he now has somewhere to sit. That's the nice thing. Because before he was kind of on a stool out in the middle. He actually has a spot on the couch now. I just thought it'd be great because the guy's doing the falsetto there. And did you notice this? I like their song so much. Check it out. I actually let them meet their goal.
There you go.
Dude's such a nice guy. He is such a great guy.
That dude, he's the Mac.
That dude.
They called you the Mac.
That's right. Now, speaking of the Mac, our friend, I caught him in a bad mood.
Uh-oh.
I caught this guy in a bad mood. I'm just going to let this roll here. I like watching this guy. He's great. But
please, Pepe, get the fuck away.
Somebody had pissed him off.
Go burn in hell. In a video game.
He was mad. In a calm way. Shit.
Fucking shit face. Fucking pig face.
I don't want to piss this guy off.
It's my fucking ass.
Somebody had come in the chat room and said some crap that really ticked me off.
Give him the rolled up pan.
And he kisses the microphone. I love it.
Nice.
Kiss of death. Huh?
The kiss of death on the microphone. This is the guy, by the way, Stein Norway. He is fun to watch.
Stein
Norway. STINNORWAY on Twitch. He's fun. Because the fun thing is, it's not only that kind of thing he does. Let me see. I
right
got him.
Next to him was our official Russian pole dancer.
We'll bring that. But also, he sings too.
We've not mentioned her in a while.
He sings. And that's why I like watching him. And he has a great wardrobe, by the way, also.
Interesting.
But he sings.
Choices.
Yeah. And he drinks coffee. He drinks coffee, Mars!
I approve.
There you go. So there you go.
There you and go. It's not Folgers.
It's totally not Folgers. So,
you said the F word. You're going to get kicked off the front page.
Well, that's true. Maybe be careful. By the way, Johnny, I found the duck girl.
The duck girl.
Yeah, the duck pond girl. She actually brought one of the ducks inside.
Aww.
Yeah.
Duck. Maybe if I did like.
Some people have dachshunds. Some people have ducks.
Yeah, and some people have cats.
Get together, you'll have some fun, right?
So drinking with ducks is her. That's who this is, by the way.
Hestia has actually made a breakthrough. She will wander into this room to demand food.
Look, Johnny, what's she drinking?
Only to
she's
demand
drinking,
food.
Drinking beer. There you go. There you go. So that's actually the girl. I was going to say drinking with ducks is actually her Instagram name. But I don't know how to pronounce that. A-N-A-X-J-O-R is her name. And normally when we see her, she's usually in a kiddie pool surrounded with ducks.
Yeah, which is awesome.
Which is awesome. That's right. This one here caught me by surprise. How do you not click on this?
Brandon, did you learn a spell from Brooke Martson? Because he would spell Brandon.
Mars, what you're hearing since you can't see it is a guy in a basement appears. And
he's getting ready to shave his entire face.
I don't know if he's getting ready to shave. He's got shaving cream, not just on his face.
Uh-oh.
On his Landon. Head, everywhere.
And his ears. And,
yes.
He's got a mouth, he's got eyes, he's got shaving cream.
Yeah, my friend Jim owns this channel, and he said I could come on here and make some new friends, because, you know, there's four balls. What you trying to say there, Nachos?
Bulls or balls?
I don't know what he said, balls. There's four balls right there, see? Four balls.
In his chat room.
There's four balls
Someone
in his chat room. There
chatted four balls to him.
Because that happens sometimes.
Nacho cheese.
So there. Like I said, that was one of those.
Someone
things.
Asked. Did he say farty pants? Someone asked him to say farty pants.
I don't know if he ever did. Pants. You know what? Looking at this picture, I know what this is. I know what this. This was a guy. I actually showed this guy. I think last week. This is the guy that drank the two beers at the same time.
Okay. Oh, I got fisted.
Odd thing. One of the fun things that happens on Twitch is if you're in a channel that somebody has a lot of really loyal viewers, and maybe you say hi or something like that. Every once in a while, there's people in there that just they'll gift you a sub to the channel. Johnny's had this happen to him.
Oh yeah.
And it's really cool. It's the way people can support people's channels that, you know, that they're already subbing to them, but they literally gift some stranger a sub or somebody they know. And then you have the rights to do, you know, you get the cool emojis or whatever, all that stuff. But that happened to me with this cat. And what I liked about this is he actually called this his cleavage cam.
Oh.
I'll show you in a minute. Why I actually clicked on this. Okay. There's a reason I clicked on this. It's not this.
For the cleavage?
So he's showing the cleavage cam, which I think is awesome that the guy actually went to the trouble.
Welcome back, dude. 5 months running, by the way.
To do a cleavage
never
cam.
Change the sub sound.
Now this guy is an actual. He's a gamer, but he also does never, the. He also talks. He's very, very, very boisterous person, but fun to
sound either.
Fun to watching.
Content that'll forever and always be Josh. That is one thing that will never.
So that's the guy. Now here's where I got to get to though. Where is it? Oh, where it says that they had gifted me. That guy actually gifted me the sub.
Cool.
Oh, I thought I had another one with that guy. Where was it? Oh, don't tell me. I hope I didn't delete it.
Well, you might have to tell us about it.
This might be. Let's see. This is it right here. Okay, stop. This is the guy. Okay, what you're seeing is a picture of my screen of the people I follow.
Yeah.
And this is what I see when I click on to his stream. This is what I see. The first thing I see.
Someone sniffing a shoe.
How can you not click on this? What WTF is going on here? That's what I think to myself.
I don't know.
Sadly enough, though, it was nothing. It was just when I clicked on it, it was just whatever. I missed it. So he was just back to he was just back to doing his thing. So there you go. Now I can't go a week without this. I got to play this guy. I love watching this guy. This is great, especially when you see the background change. This guy plays accordion, by the way, Mars. And it's an electronic accordion, and he's really freaking good.
Oh, is it a V accordion? Yes. Is it a Roland?
Oh, he's awesome, man.
Nice.
I mean, this guy can flat throw down. He has two channels, one that does repeats. This is his live channel, and he's live on there.
Yeah.
But he's a man of not very many facial expressions. But when he does this, I think he should do a whole show of nothing but this. It just seems like that's just the way it works. This guy's great. And that got a great sound. Last week I tried to play him and it actually broke. I already did that one. Okay.
We got a
follower here. Who we got the follower here? Let's see.
Kaggy Films 5. Thank you for following.
Thank you for following.
Thank you.
I need to get a sound for that. That's what I need to get.
Yeah.
Anyway, this one, I tell you, in a non-creepy way, this particular band is very...
You like Livy in a non-creepy way.
I like all of it. They come on during the day, which is what I don't like. Because I don't get to listen to them all the time. I have to listen to them on their recordings. But at lunchtime, I'll go out to my car. And I get to, almost every day, I'll go out to my car and I'll put them on the stereo and listen to them. And I mean, it's just great. She has a great voice. They have a great sound. And I can't get enough of it in that non-creepy way, like I said. But why did I do that? There we go. Sorry.
That's Livy in the Middle.
Yes, Livy in the Middle. Livy. I mean, just awesome. UK band.
Wow.
And her vocal range is scary, isn't it, Johnny?
Yeah.
I mean,
she's pretty good.
and the keyboardist, I mean, he's doing, he's got the horn section. So I'm going to let this play for a little bit because I just love watching these guys. She's got the, I didn't realize she'd get this high. And she's got a very low range when she sings. But they are great. If you get a chance, if you even if you can't catch them live, go check out their recordings because they are absolutely awesome. Livy in the Middle.
Good stuff.
Oh man, it is. It's good stuff. I could play that forever. That's good stuff.
Oh, I got notifications that Dab Daddy 420 TV is streaming.
Oh, on your phone?
Yeah, my phone let me know Dab Daddy 420 TV is streaming. So that was one of your last week's finds.
That was one of my last week's finds. I'll have to go check that out.
And I know from revisiting his channel that bitchin' cough he has is a normal occurrence on his channel.
Oh, is it? Okay. Oh, that was the guy that was actually doing the dabs, which is a smoky thing.
Dab Daddy 420
TV. They're doing dabs.
Yes, they're doing dabs. I don't know what's scary is dabs or Johnny knows what's doing or Mars knows. Okay.
Yeah, was he using a blowtorch with it?
Okay, so this is just another guitar player.
I think so.
He had
a blowtorch now.
He had to start this over again. This is a guy that I just liked it because, man, I couldn't do this for 2 hours. He's doing the headbang thing. So he's a little heavy metal. But what I really liked about this, it wasn't until I watched it today, was he's got a bagel and a spider. Come on. Is that not awesome or what?
That's
great.
That's something.
That's something. Come on.
I don't completely get it, but
he's got
cool.
He's got Kenny in the background. But it was fun to watch. I just think to myself, man, it gives me a headache just thinking. If I tried to do that for a whole show, there's no way. Absolutely no way. You know the bad thing is I don't think I. Oh, there we did. I did. There you go. So you can. If you want to check this cat out, there you go. And it's called, okay, I didn't even realize that. Bagel Spiders. Duh.
Bagel Spiders.
Bagel Spiders.
That explains it.
That's it. There you go.
I guess that's his heavy metal band name.
That would be the name of it. So there we go. That was cool.
One of those you want to eat and one you don't.
I didn't. I'm not going to play much of this because I was just, this
depends.
When I clicked on this was kind of intriguing because it was an interesting mix. Two girls, a guy on a guitar, and a dude Aww. With a fiddle.
And one cup.
And one Johnny!
Oh.
Johnny!
No.
Johnny!
No.
Oh, God.
Well, you got to put your water in something.
Oh, man. Here you go. Now, let me tell you what. Look at the viewers, Johnny.
Oh, my God.
8,603 people were watching this.
We're gonna have to watch that.
That is some next level stuff right there.
What's the name of that one?
We
didn't get the channel name.
You would ask me that. Sorry.
Yeah.
I didn't stay long enough. There we go.
Slight. Sleight. Slightly musical.
Slightly musical.
As in sleight of hand.
That.
Yes.
We'll watch that.
And I like it. They have charity, birthdays, and magic tricks as their what they're doing, which is kind of cool. Now, there's lots of people on Twitch that drum. Have you watched any of them, Johnny? The drummers?
I've seen. Well, there's a 8-bit drummer that like drums to like video game music. That
oh,
I've watched.
Okay. Well, there's a lot of different ones, and there's some really kick ass ones out there. And they're kind of fun to watch, but they're not that great when it comes to the video part. Like, I mean, it's just a person playing drums. But every once in a while, you find one that it's minimalistic and cool at the same time. Because a lot of the problems with the people that do the drumming, I mean, there's very few of them that actually can get the mix right. But I think what happens is now there's a lot of people, they're using the electronic drums. It makes it much easier to mix things in. And I just stumbled on this, and I just loved the way it sounded. I thought it was really cool. It had a great sound. This is a girl just running. So. I thought she did a really good job of mixing this. Because usually they don't have that. And the way and how these things work. Yes. Yeah. And how these damn drums work is like, I think there's the devils involved or something. I don't understand it. Because, I mean, the cymbals sound like cymbals. The drums sound, I mean, I'm guessing there's a lot of people smarter than me that make this happen. But this was fun to watch. But I thought this sounds great. Because most people used to have it too loud or too soft or whatever, and so I thought that was cool.
Yeah, it's pretty good.
Hopefully, I did. There we go. And this is, and this right here, for the people wondering what made me click on this in the first place, because normally the drummers I don't even click on. But this is what I, this is why I clicked on it. It's a jug of water. But I thought it was milk. I thought she was drinking out of a gallon jug of milk too. That's exactly what I thought. But that's actually just a gallon jug of water she had. So
you're like, oh boy, we're gonna watch some puke. No, it's okay.
Yeah, jug milk, play drums, what could go wrong? Right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, Johnny. This is where we, this is where we're gonna play the game. Dune's doing it wrong.
Why did Dune's doing it wrong?
Dune's doing it wrong. For Sir Mars, so you'll know what's going on here. There are videos that I play that Johnny thinks
there's a pair of shorts on the screen.
There's a pair of shorts on this. This is. Let's see if Johnny and I see the same thing. Great soundtrack.
Nice jean shorts.
Nice. You got the some little.
Nice jean
she's
shorts.
Got the little ears going.
She's got.
She's
jean
cooking.
Shorts.
She's. And I'm looking at this.
I think they call those jorts. I think they're called jorts, right?
And see, the whole time this is on,
Russian woman. No,
Dune is like, check out that 1980 CRT TV right there. There you go.
I approve that.
That's what Dune's looking at. This is a problem, Johnny.
I didn't even notice there was a shelf for it. I didn't even notice there was a shelf for the TV, to be honest.
There we go.
I was checking out those jorts.
Now to be fair for the people out there, where's the picture? Where's the? Wait a minute. I got to come back to this. Here it is. So, yeah. There it is.
She's got jorts.
Tigra? T-I-G-G-R-A?
Tigra.
Tigra. God, I can't read nothing. Can I ask a question?
Oh.
Go for it.
Yeah.
Was that a question?
Are so expensive.
Yeah, let's just move on.
Someone, no, wait, I want to follow that channel to find out what the deal is.
Oh, you want to see?
Is she?
Which one are you talking about?
The girl with her foot in her mouth.
Well, I don't think it's her channel. There's a guy on screen. Oh, and I didn't. You can't see it anyway because I. Oh, there it is. Well,
now is she kissing her?
Hey, look at the
toe?
Look at the name of the channel. Look at the name of the channel, Johnny. Look at that.
It's my face is covering it.
Quad
the God.
Quad the God. Yes. Interesting.
Okay, I'm intrigued. I'm intrigued by this.
Okay.
Wait, by the toe or the name?
The name.
Both.
Hey, now last week we had an episode of What Not to Do at Work. Do you remember that, Johnny? The girl at work that was counting all the money, and then she rolled it up and she threw it in the unlocked drawer and then took three steps out.
And showed off.
I just want you to know, it's still working. All right. Still gainfully employed.
Okay.
That's awesome.
Same place.
She had a problem. There's a machine that she was tasked to run these receipts through. And she was running the receipts and talking while she was doing this. And they weren't really going through the machine.
I went from looking like this to looking like this.
Oh, that's not good.
That's a problem.
You know, 8-tracks have a tendency of doing that sometimes.
So the poor girl. This is one of those things, if you're going to stream at work, pay attention to what you're doing. just saying. I did not click on her name because I still feel kind of weird about that.
If you just let me know what her name is.
Okay. Okay, I'll do that. Okay, now this girl here, I've watched her several times. Her name is Liv Sticks. I think I'll get the gun, but I've seen her a few times. She lives in California. And okay. I clipped this for the sole purpose of just to let you guys know out there, you need to get your game into gear.
Oh,
okay.
Because you can be replaced.
Hard yet. It takes 3 days.
I'm just letting you know. So, Sir Mars,
yes.
This girl has, what, Johnny, what would you call this? What would you say?
A carpool partner.
Yes.
Okay.
That's made out of,
not flesh.
Not flesh, no.
Wow. He's got great googly eyes.
Yeah, he's got googly eyes.
Okay.
And he's got his name on, says, hello, my name is Humberto.
Now, is this to get in the carpool lane, or is she really a new boyfriend?
Johnny, you know what? I'll just let this play, and I'll let you decide. Liv Sticks, by the way, she's fun to watch. She's very outgoing, very boisterous.
She's got cleavage.
She's very cute.
Oh!
Did you say she lives in the Bay Area?
And she just licked him on the face and kissed him, so.
Man, I missed this is.
Yeah, so.
This is better than the average male, though. Oh, Lord.
You guys better step your game up, is all I can say.
Shut up. Wow. It is a crunch.
I think she's just doing it for carpool.
Well, you know, possibly. I don't know.
Yeah, but she made out with it a little bit.
Yeah, you know. I'm just telling you, she's fun to watch. She is. This is the first time I've seen Humbert.
This is
California for you here. So just.
Have you ever dated a girl like this?
No. No. No.
That would be an experience.
No, I have not. So there you go.
Might be something that single people might need to put on the bucket list.
You need to
date a crazy girl like that. And I say that with all the love of the world because
yes,
I'm sure she's awesome.
But you should follow.
She has got that crazy energy.
She does. She does all kinds of crazy. She goes into malls and stuff like that. It's fun to watch. It's absolutely a blast. It is. The people that stream, I have to give them credit because I just can't imagine walking around with the camera and talking in the camera like that because I would just feel weird.
Oh.
But they love it. And she does, what you don't know right now, and see what it says, longboarding, she rides one of those electric skateboards and holds that camera out while she's doing and talks. I mean, it's freaking cool. It's cool. So if you get a chance, check her out. Very fun.
Liv Sticks.
Yeah. All kinds of fun stuff on this page. All kinds of fun. I clip this guy for the simple reason, great voice. What a voice.
Mit so Würfelzucker irgendwie.
No idea what he's saying.
Ich weiß noch nicht mehr, wie ich das zu mir genommen habe.
Auf jeden Fall irgendwie was mit
Zucker. But a great voice.
Sag mal, Jack, was machst du denn da?
He's talking to the dog.
Hä? Warte mal.
He's got fun stuff going on around his. He's got whatever this thing is. It looks like fun. What happens in Vegas stays in Vegas. I like that. Anyway, that was it. That's why I clicked on that one. Now, Johnny, here's another one.
Jeans.
Here's another one. This was a splash page, what I call it, for the people out there. When people go, and I don't know if it's called splash, whatever, when they go to like break or whatever, they'll run some static pictures or a video or whatever.
Okay.
That's what this girl did. But I clicked on this for a reason, because we need this, but not what you think. Okay? For the people out there watching, we need this. But it's not what you think. Okay. Can somebody please find that for me? I need this.
A song?
No, it's an animated rabbit on a pole dancing.
Oh.
This is something. Okay. This needs to happen. Can somebody?
That yes. We do need that.
Can somebody please make that happen? Thank you. I don't ask for much. Just for a little. So there you go. I don't know if I actually did I actually if you want to watch I actually did. Let me see if I got that.
So that's better than
that was actually this one. She was actually doing a cooking show. That's why I clicked on it.
Oh.
That's actually her right there. Because some of the cooking some of the cooking things are kind of fun to watch.
Yeah.
So. All right. You know what? We are at that point, Johnny.
It's time for the
spotlight of the week. And guess what I did? I made an actual artist spotlight of the week. Twitch artist spotlight of the week.
Now, our test.
Oh, fuck off. Did I spell that wrong? God dang it. Oh my God.
It's time for the R test spotlight.
How's it spelled? Help me out here, Johnny. Huh?
Artist. A-R-T-I-S-T.
Oh, why did I spell that? This is why we can't have This is why we can't have nice things. Everybody's LOLing me now. I'm just going to let this play. Now, at first, I wasn't sure what was going on with this guy's... I thought he had, like knee socks on, but actually what he has is jeans that are just torn. Because that caught my eye. I was like, what's going on? I wasn't sure what was going on here. But I can't believe I spelled artist with an E.
Meanwhile, someone sent in a link with the bunny dance.
Oh, did we? Oh, gosh. Keep that one. Thank you. But this is a guy who plays guitar, and he's also a looper. I watched this guy for, like, a long time. It was very cool. I actually have his links on either side of the... his Facebook page and his Twitter page. His Twitter page, same as the name on Twitch, which I'll bring up. But this was this morning I found this, like 8 o'clock this morning. So you have to, you know, even if...
Awesome.
You know, just one of those things, if I have no idea where he's at. Very cool, though. This is just one of those things. I just can't imagine being knowing how to do this. So you people that are sleeping in late on Saturday mornings, this is what you miss if you don't click.
I missed it.
You missed it.
I missed it, but I didn't sleep in.
There we go.
I got two cats. I think I can sleep in.
Oh, is that what it is? I tell you what, here's by the way. There we go. You notice I spelled artist spotlight correct here. So it's the Guitar Baron is his name.
Good stuff.
So that was cool. So I thought what I would do, you know what? I thought I'll just let this guy take us out. That's what I figured. Just to be different, we would let that happen.
Yeah.
Because this was kind of like a complete song where he started the loop and then put it together because he's cool like that. So go check him out if you get a chance. And like I said, I wasn't going to have an artist spotlight this week. It's just one of those things that happened because I was up at the right time and boom, that happened. So speaking about being around at the right time, Johnny, tomorrow is Monday.
Yeah, tomorrow is looking good for Brian Blues.
Okay.
And besides, you know, I got to talk more about plumbing and all the details of that.
Exactly.
So, we're going to, you know, we'll be doing a little bit of plumbing on...
Insert title here.
And yes. Also, you know, I got my own, like, artist spotlight I've been meaning to get to that I keep forgetting to. There's a guy that plays drums in the parking lot of a auto dealership.
You'll record it live.
It's not
obviously.
Live.
It's not it's, live, it's but, not, but look, you'll be recorded live, obviously.
But there's something funny about that, and that he has a YouTube channel devoted to just playing drums along to songs while going, "Hey there," as people looking at cars walk by, and I, you know, I don't know whose idea it was to hire a drummer to just play drums to songs in the dealership parking lot, and if he's actually driving up sales or not, but this exists on the internet, so we have to talk about
it. I think
it.
That totally works, though. I think that totally yeah. works. Mars, I would stop and buy something just because of that.
A I think car? That, you'd buy a car for that?
Oh, sorry, I missed that part. I would go it's in and get an air freshener good. From the... There we go.
Sure, yeah, there you go.
So there we go. So that's tomorrow, 8 p.m. Eastern on NHBRadio.com. Also, Johnny, I think... Does Johnny, it's on a YouTube channel, so if you follow NHB Radio, he tweets it on there. And then,
my YouTube channel is youtube.com/JohnnyGators.
There you
and,
go.
And, you know, you want to follow the. No, not with the Z.
Not with
Gators
the
Z. Is with an S.
I'm just. This is me. This is my day.
You know, there was this TV show on PBS mm-hmm. called Learn to Read.
I'm right here, Johnny. I'm right here. You know? You know what I'm talking about? Oh, God.
That was great TV to get stuck to, wasn't it?
That hurt. Oh, man.
You made so many reading mistakes this week, though. I had to bag on
you.
Oh,
you did. You dad. You dad? I just said, oh, my God. I can't speak either. Oh, man. That guitar baron, did I mention that?
It's all the dead hookers. It's all the dead. It gets exhausting after time, you know?
Oh, God. Just... Why?
Maybe it's a metal poisoning from the straw.
That's right. Johnny's talking about, by the way, that guy.
Yes, that guy.
There you go.
There we go. I clicked it off. man. So don't forget. So anyway, so Monday, Johnny, 8 p.m. Eastern tomorrow.
And heck, Mars, what are you doing tomorrow at 8?
I'm actually headed to Virginia, so.
Ah, so you'll call in.
I thought maybe you were washing your hair.
No, I don't. I got a haircut, so I don't have to do that as much.
I kid.
There you go.
Well, head out to visit family for the Thanksgiving. Yeah. I take it.
Yes. Possibly we'll see.
Yes, I have to figure out what this cold weather thing is. So.
Wait, Virginia. That's not that far from Massachusetts, so you could pop up for a day at some point during the week.
Uh-huh.
That's true. It could be.
Yeah. I just grab an Uber. How's
so we'll that? See if Tuesday Vamp will be around. We don't know. I'm not sure about this week if Outlaw Radio will be on Saturday or not. If they are, they'll be on. If not, they won't be. I will be on Saturday night doing the 5-Hit Show with Dune on Heat FM, also on this Twitch channel. Back on Sunday, possibly. No, Johnny will be out of town. We'll figure. We'll play that by ear on Sunday.
No. I'm only taking a day trip for Thanksgiving. I'm not going for a long weekend.
Okay,
this year.
That sounds cool. Well, I tell you what, I'm gonna go ahead. I'm gonna go ahead and just end this, and we'll just let this play out, and I will catch you cast next week because I think this is worth listening to. So, peace out, people. Definitely. Take care. Twitch Spotlight. Go check them out.
Good night.
Good night, good girl. Thank you for
Thank you.
There you go, people. Thanks for tuning in. And by the way, Tracy, I didn't see. I actually saw you over on the other screen. I'm sorry. I didn't catch you were in the room. Thank you, iVlog, for putting me on the front page just in time for me to go back off. But don't forget, next week, I'll be back. All that good stuff. Take care, people.
Game over, man.
I'm glad that's over.
Man, that was awful.
Boy, I know. You know what I hated most? What? Everything. Everything stuck.
If I'm not back in 5 minutes, just wait longer.
Let's blow this joint.
It's time to blast off for Dreamland. Don't go away mad. Just go away.
Let's call it a day. Everybody, go home.
Good night, lady.
See you later, alligator.
Go in peace, Cinemore. I'm out of here.
Now, run along and play with your little toys.
Hmm? Oh! It just gets worse and worse.
Please come again.
I have exorcised the demon. The house is clear.
Not.
We are leaving.
This tape will self-destruct in 5 seconds.
Oi, shoot the radio.